Now, pickling, bottling, canning, some of the oldest methods of preserving food, and lately they have been making a comeback.
Sure have, but with this has come a pesky problem. How do you get the labels off used jars? Well, I got one of our viewers so het up, she wrote to us for help, so I headed to Levin to get her out of a pickle.
Come on, girls. Come on, silly belly. Come
on. On a goat farm.
Come on. There you go.
15 minutes out of Levin.
Oh, they're very friendly. Here's my Shirley.
Steph Cook's got a problem.
This is ridiculous.
A former Wellington City Councillor.
18 years for my sins. It was great.
She even did a work experience stint on Fair Go.
I'll never forget it. It was a load of fun.
The story she worked on, a Fair Go classic.
Putting plastic bottles full of water on your front lawn, and that would stop dogs coming along and pooing on your front lawn, in theory, but it turned out to be a bit of an urban myth.
Needless to say, Steph's used to solving sticky situations. But this one, well, it's proving a little more challenging.
These blinky jars. Now, you know, I live in this lovely place and I've got produce that I like to pickle and relish and things like that. And you get given jars or you have jars that you've used and so on. But honestly, the hardest bit of the whole thing is getting the labels off. Well, not so much the labels. The labels will soak off quite easily. It's the glue. I've tried thinners, I've tried nail polish remover, I've tried meths, I've tried white vinegar, I've tried baking soda. None of it works.
What's your go-to method at the moment?
Boiling water, dishwashing liquid. Let it soak for, 10 minutes or so, and then just scrub it like mad with a wire, you know, Goldilocks thingy.
It's not quite doing the trick, so we took to the streets of Taitoko Levin to see if we could find an answer.
There is a cameraman there, he is shooting.
I soak them in really hot water.
Tweezers.
Store-bought adhesive remover.
Put hot water in a sink, and you put that in there with the soap, and then you wipe it off.
And then I've got a sharp knife that I'll run up and down, and then one of those scourers.
Lots of lovely people.
Kakite from Levin, Taitoko, out!
And lots of helpful suggestions, so it's time to relive my glory days of high school chemistry.
This is feeling like a fail, I think.
Does not smell good. This just feels like a waste of good peanut butter.
And while we're talking peanut butter, we should mention these guys.
Reusing jars is wonderful.
Because they've gone above and beyond by including label removal instructions on their jars.
I just looked into it and I realised the easiest way of getting the labels off was to soften up the glue. And you can do that by just filling the jar with hot water. And that makes the label relatively easy to come off.
And sure enough...
Wow, that's really impressive.
Yep, a tick for picks trick. Unfortunately, it doesn't work on all jars, but fear not, because here it is, folks, the Fair Go tried and true method for getting the gunk off jars. Soak jar for 15 minutes in a mixture of boiling hot water, dish liquid, and white vinegar. Gently remove label. If there's still adhesive remaining, cover it in a paste of cooking oil and baking soda for 15 minutes, then use a scourer to scrub clean. Time to share our wisdom with Steph.
We'll do it, Jamie Oliver, and just chuck a bit of this and a bit of that.
So the theory here is the oils help loosen the adhesive.
Okay.
And then you get a little bit of abrasion from the baking soda.
I think that's working. And not having to use toxic chemicals and things like that, because it kind of just doesn't go with the whole notion of recycling and, you know, pickling your own and things like
well,
that.
Well, that's exactly right.
So the side that we've done is all sparkly and shiny. Look, it looks great.
This might be a career high for me, Steph.
I need to work out whether this beats the plastic bottles on the lawn.